देवं श्री राधा कृष्ण पादान सहगणललिता श्री विशाखान्वितांश जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदि गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे साधु साधु तदा नथिनी चोचारकण जगदाच हरे कृष्ण। सो विल डिस्कस दिस टॉपिक रिजल्ट्स ऑफ स्पिरिचुअल पोटेंस प्रैक्टिसेस ऑफर्ड इन द स्क्रिप्चर्स रियल और एग्जैगरेटेड। Results of spiritual practices. I am not taking religious practices here. Religious practices means that which are given in Karmakanda section of Vedas. This laptop needs charging. So religious practices, that Karma Kanda section, or most part of the Vedas, they contain this Karma Kanda section. Only the final portions. Yes. Only the final portions of the Vedas called Upanishads, they contain spiritual wisdom. Prabhupada, in Bhagavad Gita purport 2.45, he said Upanishads mark the beginning of transcendental life. So in Vedas there are four sections, four divisions. Every Veda, Rigveda, Yajurveda, Samaveda, Atharva Veda, all these four Vedas contain four divisions. Samhitas, Brahmanas and Aranyakas. So Samhita, Brahmana, Aranyaka and Upanishads. So first three mostly deal with this Karma Kanda section. So some religious rituals which give basically some material benefits. So here we are discussing spiritual practices, more specifically or more precisely devotional principles or devotional practices. So results of devotional practices offered in the scriptures. So results, there are some positive results and there are negative results. So positive results means by doing such and such devotional practice, you will attain liberation, like that. For instance, in South India, every year on Vaikuntha Ekadasi day, in all these temples, Vishnu temples, they organize some Vaikuntha Dwara, and by passing through that Vaikuntha Dwara, it is said in the scriptures that one will attain Vaikuntha. So like that, and like that there are many such results are promised. I will read some of the examples. So in Haribhakti Sudodaya, it is mentioned about going to temple. By going to temple, what happens? Pravishan alayam Vishnur, by entering into the alaya. Abode of alaya means it's a temple of Vishnu, we can say. Darshanartham Shubhaktiman. Na bhuya pravi. Pravishena matu kukshi karagraha sudhihi. The intelligent person who enters the temple of Vishnu with devotion to see the Lord does not again enter the prison of a mother's womb. So by going there, one will not again enter into the womb of mother. Or another example is, okay, regarding parikrama of the Lord, by circumambulating the temple, Vishnu pradakshini kurvan yastatra vartate punaha tad evava vartanam tasya punar na vartate bhave. If a person circumambulates Vishnu and returns to the same spot, that returning guarantees that he does not return to another birth. He does not return to, or he doesn't take birth again, or he doesn't come back to this material world. So like that. Some more examples we can see. This is about serving the Lord in the temple. Muhurtam ya muhurtardam yas tishte dhari mandire sayati paramam sthanam kimu shushushane rataha. If one remains in the temple of the Lord for one muhurta, approximately 48 minutes, or even half a muhurta, that means 24 minutes, he goes to the supreme abode. What then to speak of a person engaged in paricharya of the Lord? So just by staying, spending some 48 minutes in Lord's temple, so one will go to supreme abode. So like that. Another example is about Sankirtana. This we will not discuss. Like this, there are many such positive results are said, and there are negative results also. By not doing this, one goes to hell, etc., etc. So now, so the question arises whether these are real or exaggerated, and particularly for devotees, this may be discouraging. Why devotees it may be discouraging? Because we do so many things. We get up early in the morning, we do Mangalarti, we do chant 16 rounds, so many services we do. Why we have to do so much services? We have to just do this much, right? Enter into temple, just 24 minutes you be there, half a muhurta, or 48 minutes if not 24, just to make it more, make our position more secure. We can be at 48 minutes. So why we have to do so much devotional service? Some kind of discouragement it is. Or once in a year or once in lifetime I'll just enter into Vaikuntha Dwara. Then I'll go to Vaikuntha. Why I need to do so many activities, so many spiritual activities, devotional activities. So like this question comes. Or in other way, if you think the negative result, we are engaged in devotional service, and one time if you don't do Nirjala Ekadasi, you will go to hell. If you hear such descriptions, then it becomes like a devotee asked me a question on this, and he said, it is a very unjust or disproportionate from Lord's side. Or we are just like Christians, they present their God that very cruel God, if you make, if you don't pray to God, then you will go to hell, like that. So it is disproportionate, like that we think. So the question, or some doubt may come that, oh, these are all exaggerations, they are not real. So such kind of thought may come, but actually they are not exaggerations. So Prabhupada says that they are not exaggerations, they are real. I will read a quote from Prabhupada later, little later. So, but if they are not exaggerations, how to understand them? Question arises. So first thing is that these results are not meant for devotees. Generally, results means often some material results are also told, or liberation is, up to liberation, these results are told. Because liberation is not the goal of devotees, therefore this is not meant for devotees. I'll give one more example about that. Another devotee had asked me a question. What is that? This Bhagavad Gita, Gita Mahatmya is there. One verse is there in that. Mala nirmochanam pumsa jalasnanam dine dine sakrat gitamrata snanam samsara malanashanam. So by daily taking bath, we are cleansing ourselves of dirt. But if you take bath in Bhagavad Gita, what happens? We'll become completely samsara mala. That means we become fully liberated from material existence. So like that it is said. But there are, we hear, we read Bhagavad Gita once, twice. Or many people, they memorize full Bhagavad Gita, recite it. So does it, do they get this result like that? Question. So these are liberation, often these results of liberation, up to liberation, other material results are also, you know, are what they are offered. So they are promised. But liberation is promised. Up to liberation, these results are promised. This is not actually the goal of devotional service or devotees. By engaging in devotional service, we are not supposed to attain liberation. Our purpose of doing devotional service is to achieve love of God. That we should remember first. The goal of bhakti is love of Godhead. Rati it is called. Rati or bhava, prema it is. So spontaneous attachment and love for Krishna. That is the goal of bhakti. Goal of bhakti is not to attain dharma, artha, kama and moksha. So dharma, artha, kama, moksha is attained by other Vedic followers, not devotees. So devotees, they don't want even liberation also. So as long as this desire for bhakti and mukti is there in our heart, we will never be able to relish the pure nectar of bhakti actually. So Rupa Goswami stated that, and he gave so many verses in which, if you want you can read, Prabhupada has translated Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu into English, The Nectar of Devotion it is called as, that book. In that third and fourth chapter you can read there, you know, so basically Rupa Goswami has quoted so many verses. Devotee is not desiring even liberation also. What to speak of? Material sense gratification. So material happiness. So devotees want only service to Krishna. They only want to just love Krishna. That's all. Nothing else. That is the goal of their devotional service. So now then the results which are offered in these scriptures, they are meant for materialistic, pious materialistic people. Pious materialistic people means those who are Vedic followers, but they are not devotees of Krishna. There are many karmakandis, karma mimamsakas. So they follow Vedas and Dharma very seriously, strictly. They never do any sinful activities. Such people, and their goal of life is often Dharma Artha, or mostly Dharma Artha, Kama and Moksha. Of course, Karma Mimamsakas, they don't want even Moksha, they only want Swarga. So, some there may be Jnanis and Yogis who want to attain Moksha also. So, basically these four results they want. Dharma, Artha, Kama, Moksha. So, such non-devotees, if they do some devotional service, what happens? They achieve their desired result. So, that means these results which are offered in the these scriptures, they are meant for non-devotees of Krishna, but they are pious Vedic followers, and in certain cases for some impious souls also, sinful people also. Even if they do some devotional activities, they will also get liberation. I will come back to point. So generally those who are engaged in karma, jnana, yoga, ashtanga yoga, so they cannot achieve liberation and the desired results of their practices without following some element of bhakti. They need to follow some bhakti yoga. They need to follow some element of bhakti yoga, or some angas, some limbs of devotional service or some devotional practices. Otherwise, they will not get the result of following their own path or practices. So bhakti is required ultimately. Therefore, when such pious, highly pious souls who are engaged following dharma, who are following Vedas, those who never do any sinful activities, when they come in contact with some devotional practice, they immediately achieve liberation. And in certain cases, some sinful people also may achieve liberation. Why I am saying certain cases? Because some people who take advantage of devotional principles, okay, I'll do sinful activities also, and I will, once in a while, I'll come and do this. Not such people. So, those who, without their knowledge, without a wrong attitude, unconsciously, those who do engage in devotional service, they will get, basically we should not have that, namno balad yasya hi papa buddhi hi, about chanting holy names it is there. Seventh offense is to commit sinful activities on the strength of the holy name. If those who don't have that kind of shameful attitude, so even they will also, some sinful people also will achieve liberation by engaging certain devotional activities. So, and also third reason is, second reason is, these results are offered in the Vedic literature, scriptures, so that to attract them to devotional service, even though it may be mixed devotional service, mixed with their material desires. So if they engage in devotional service, what happens? Akamo sarvakamo va moksha kama udaradi thivrena bhakti yogena yajeta purusham param. So those who engage in devotional service to Krishna, what happens? They will attain love of Godhead. Although they may be akama, sarvakama, moksha kama, they may be desiring, they may be free from all desires, they may have many desires, or they may be desiring liberation, they will also attain pure devotional service or, love of Godhead, if they come in contact, some or other come in contact with Supreme Lord. There is another verse also. Satyam dvishat arthitam arthitam ranam naivartado yat punar arthito. दट वर्स इन फिफ्त कैंटो ऑफ श्रीमद्भागवतम नैवार्थतो यत् पुनरर्थितो अर्थितायतः स्वयं विदते भजताम अनिच्छताम इच्छापि दानम निजपाद पल्लवम. सो कृष्णा व्हेन समन कम्स टू कृष्णा विथ मटेरियल डिजायर्स, सो व्हाट ही डज कृष्णा, इंस्टेड ऑफ गिविंग हिम मटेरियल फुलफिलिंग हिज मटेरियल डिजायर्स, ही गिव्स हिज लोटस फीट टू हिम, ऑल्दो ही इज नॉट डिजायरिंग हिज लोटस फीट. So in this way, mercifully Lord gives him his devotional service. This verse was expanded by Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami in a very nice way. Krishna is speaking. In the words of Krishna, he says that this foolish person, he comes to me asking for poison. But I am not foolish. I am intelligent. Ami vigya. I don't give him poison. I will give him swacharanamrata, nectar of my lotus feet, he says. So in this way, going to Krishna with material desires, it is like going and asking for some poison, actually. Because for Atma, for soul, only devotional service will make happy. Nothing else will make happy. Any amount of material achievement, material success, so our kingdom, wealth, opulence, etc. will not make soul happy. So it will be poisonous for them. And about Ambarish Maharaj also it is said, kamam chadase natu kama kamyaya yatuttama shloka janashraya ratihi. So it is said that Ambarish Maharaj, he never desired anything sense gratification. And in fact, he made sense gratification, he completely curbed it by engaging in devotional service and attained rati, attachment for the Lord. He attained love for the Lord. So in this way, if the materialistic people, so when they are attracted to Krishna's devotional service, they will give up their material tendencies. So that is the reason such material results are offered there. But they can get them. It's not that it is just promise. They get fulfilled. But somehow or other, if they come in contact with the Lord, they will become purified also. That is also there. Another thing is that, another question may come here is that, are they so powerful enough just by spending some time in the temple, or by circumambulating the Lord, or by offering some lamp to the Lord, that we will achieve liberation? Are they so powerful? So yes, they are very powerful. Because they are spiritual activities and they are connected with Krishna. And Krishna can give any benediction. They are recording their potency. I would like to read a verse from Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. So, alaukika padarthanam achintya shakti ridrashi bhavam tadvishayam chapi ya sahaiva prakashayet. So, this is particularly told about five angas of devotional service, five potent forms of devotional service. So among all bhakti principles, devotional principles, hearing Srimad Bhagavatam, chanting holy names, worshipping deity form of the Lord, associating with the devotees and residing in Mathura, they are considered as most powerful. About them it is said, the inconceivable power of these extraordinary five angas. Actually it says, alaukika padarthanam achintya shakti ridrashi. So because they are transcendental activities, therefore they possess inconceivable potency. भावं तद विषयं चापि या सहैव प्रकाशयेत. जस्ट लाइक यू गो एंड स्टैंड इन फ्रंट ऑफ अ ओशन एंड यू कैन सी देयर द पावरफुल यू नो वेव्स कमिंग. Then we understand how powerful it is, material energies. Now some spiritual activities, how much powerful they may be actually. So that we should understand. Alaukika padarthanam achintya shakti ridrashi bhavam tad vishayam chapi ya sahaiva prakashayet. So it is about bhavam, about attaining bhava stage, tad vishayam, the object of that, Krishna, simultaneously manifest in the heart. Anyway, my point is that if they can give Krishna to us and manifest love of Godhead in your heart, what giving liberation is, what is, what big thing is that? Or any material benediction. So it is insignificant. Okay, next I will read another, next verse of, this is Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu 1.1. There is another quote here from Srimad Bhagavatam, first I will read that. This is from 10th canto, Srimad Bhagavatam, 12th chapter, verse number 39. Just now what I read, Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, it is Bhakti BRS, Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu 1.2.244. And now Srimad Bhagavatam 10.12.39. It is said, Sakrad yadanga pratimantar ahita manomai bhagavatim dado gatim स एव नित्यात्म सुखानुभूत्यभि युधस्तमायोंथर गतो हि किं पुनः. दिस वर्स इज स्पोकन आफ्टर कृष्णा किल्ड अगासुरा. इट सेज इफ इवन ओनली वंस आर इवन बाय फोर्स वन ब्रिंग्स द फॉर्म ऑफ द सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉडहेड इनटू वंस माइंड, one can attain the supreme salvation by the mercy of Krishna, as Agasura did. Because when Krishna killed Agasura, and he attained liberation, so there this verse is spoken. What then is to be said of those in whose hearts the supreme personality of Godhead enters when he appears as an incarnation, are those who always think of the lotus feet of the Lord, who is the source of transcendental bliss for all living entities, and by whom all illusion is completely removed. So even, you know, Krishna gives liberation even to demons. So that is one of the qualities of Krishna. Hatari gati dhayaka. Hatari gati dhayaka means whomever he kills, he gives them liberation. If demons can attain liberation, why not devotees? So therefore these angas are very powerful. Okay, that was about form of the Lord. By if you bring form of the Lord in our heart or meditate on the form of the Lord, that is what is the reason. So now Rupa Goswami, he particularly says about this point which we are discussing. Results offered, results of spiritual practices offered in the scriptures, whether they are real or... So he says, what he says about that. This is Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu 1.2.245. केशमचित क्वचित अंगानाम यत् क्षुद्रम शूयते पलम बहिर्मुख प्रवृत्तैतत् किंतु मुख्यम पलम रतिः. सो केशमचित क्वचित अंगानाम, इन सम भक्ति अंगास आर डिवोशनल प्रिंसिपल्स, यत् क्षुद्रम शूयते पलम, सम इनसिग्निफिकेंट material desire, material, sorry, not material, insignificant results are offered. I am not using material. Why? Because here in the translation of this verse, actually, the translator has used it as material results. In some of the verses quoted from the scriptures, material results are attributed to the angas for attracting persons possessing material consciousness. However, the main result of these angas is rati or bhava. So here translator has kshudram, he has translated it as material, but it also includes liberation also. Why? Because in the beginning of Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, he has already said that in front of devotional service, even liberation is also insignificant. Kshudra it is. Moksha lagutakrata, he says. Moksha, even liberation is also insignificant. So, kshudram shuyate palam. Palam means results. So, insignificant results are offered. Bahir mukha pravrityaitad. Kintu mukhyam palam ratihi. So, Rupa Goswami says, this is only for bahir mukha. Bahir mukha means those who are non-devotees. Opposite to bahir mukha is antar mukha. Or those who are sevan mukha. For them, this result is for them. Kintu mukhyam phalam ratihi. Mukhya phala. The main result of all the devotional principles is rati, love for Krishna. Rati is translated as attachment to Krishna. It is bhava, bhava bhakti, or prema bhakti. Bhava is the beginning of prema, love. So, love is the main result of mukhyam palam ratihi of devotional service. So, all other results which are mentioned in the scriptures, including even liberation, is also, it is meant for these bahir mukhas. This word is also there, pravrityaitat. Pravrityaitat means to attract them to or engage them in devotional service so that they also will become pure devotees. So, bahir mukha pravrityaitat kintu mukhya palam ratihi, it is mentioned. So, result is, like I mentioned, bahir mukha means in this mainly those Vedic followers, pious Vedic followers, those who follow Veda strictly and dharma. So, if they do little devotional service, they achieve all those results, including liberation. So, but they may not get the main result. Main result is what? So, bhava or rati. So, that is also said, that sudurlabha, love of Godhead is very rarely attained, it is. There are six characteristics of pure devotional service which are mentioned in the beginning, right? Klesha Agni, beginning of Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. So, Klesha Agni, Shubhada, Moksha, Laguta, Krita, Sudarlabho, Sandrananda, Visheshatma, Shri Krishna, Akarshani, Chasa. So, Klesha Agni, it destroys all the miseries. Shubhada, it brings all auspiciousness in our life. Moksha lagutakrata, even moksha, liberation becomes insignificant in front of bhakti. And sudurlabha, it is rarely attained and it attracts even Krishna, Shri Krishna Akarshani. And the very nature of this devotional service is condensed happiness, condensed bliss. Sandrananda, Visheshatma. These are the six characteristics of devotional service. So, sudurlabha is rarely attained, it is. So, there Rupa Goswami says, Krishna gives liberation, but he doesn't give pure bhakti. He doesn't give love of Godhead. He doesn't give bhava, bhava bhakti. Therefore, it is rarely attained, it is. So, why he doesn't like to give? Because once he gives, he has to sell out himself, it is said. Like for Pandavas were pure devotees, they had so much attachment and love for Krishna. So, what all Krishna had to do for them? He was completely sold out to Pandavas. So similarly, Krishna gives liberation easily, but he doesn't give devotional service. So these insignificant results which are offered, including even liberation, so that is easily given by Krishna. If these pious materialistic people are certain sinful people also, if they do certain devotional activities, they will achieve liberation. But Krishna will not give this love of Godhead. Srila Prabhupada, in his rendering of this verse from Bhagavad Gita, Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu 1.2.245, Prabhupada, it is in the 13th chapter of Nectar of Devotion. I will read one paragraph. So Prabhupada tells about these results. He says, I'll just read. In these statements about devotional service, sometimes it may appear that the results have been overestimated. But actually there is no overestimation. So clearly Prabhupada says, it is not exaggeration or overestimation. They are real. Some devotees, as revealed scriptures give evidence, have had immediate results by such association, although this is not possible for all. For example, the Kumaras immediately became devotees simply by smelling the incense in the temple. This is described in the third canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. So four Kumaras, they went to the gate of Vaikuntha. Then Lord came there. Lord Vaikuntha, Vishnu came there, Narayana. And the breeze which carried the fragrance of Tulasi leaves that were offered to Lord Narayana, that fragrance entered into the nostrils of these four Kumaras. And immediately, so they all symptoms of love or devotional service manifested in ecstasy, they manifested in their heart. Now this example, if you analyze, four Kumaras were not devotees, then how could they go to Vaikuntha? Question Maharaj. Actually, they did not enter into Vaikuntha, they were at the gate of Vaikuntha. But they were highly elevated souls, spiritual, they are spiritual. They are not even materialistic pious souls, they were spiritual. They were the self-realized souls, Brahmavadis. But they didn't have devotional service to Vishnu or Krishna. So they were like more attached to impersonal philosophy. Four Kumaras, they reside in Janaloka. And in Janaloka, what they do, people, residents of Janaloka, they just discuss philosophy. But they are liberated souls. They are, you know, liberated in the sense that they know that they are not these bodies. They are on Brahma Bhuta stage. Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma Na Shochati Na Kangshati. But they don't engage in devotional service. Anyway, four Kumaras, they went there. And by just little connection with devotional principle, what happens? So immediately, love of God had manifested in their heart. Some devotees, as revealed scriptures give evidence, have immediately immediate results of such association, although this is not possible for all. So now this is another thing. We may smell, like in 11th canto of Bhagavatam, Uddhava says, Tvayopabhukta Shraganda Hasalankara Charchitaha Uchishta Bhojanam Dasat Tavamayam Jayemai. Anyway, I had memorized this verse, but now I am forgetting. But so Tvayopabhukta Shragandas. So whatever Gandha means, you know, Gandha, it can be some pregnance substances, oils, fragrant oils, the sandalwood is also offered to the Lord. So and flowers, tulasi leaves, or even bhoga, cooked items, which are offered to the Lord, Tvayopabhukta, after Lord enjoys them, and then when we receive them as mercy of Krishna, we honor them, then what happens? We conquer over all illusions. So now, that is what happened with four Kumaras. And we also do all these things, activities, devotees. But we don't get the same result, right? So here that is what Prabhupada says. Although this is not possible for all, means it depends on our own surrender, our dedication in bhakti. But by doing these things again and again, we will also one day get result. Therefore, Rupa Goswami has also said that we have to be enthusiastic, we have to be patient, and we have to be confident. Utsaha, nichaya, dhairya, tat tat karma pravartanat, and keep doing these things. So, and every time when we do these things, we will get some result at least, not that we don't get any result. But we may not get the same result. But here the point is, Kumaras, they were already pious, very highly elevated beings, spiritually. They were liberated souls. So then they achieved devotional service. Bilva Mangala Thakura simply heard about Krishna and then immediately gave up his beautiful girlfriend and started out for Mathura and Vrindavan, where he became a perfect Vaishnava. So these statements are not overestimations, nor are they stories. They are actual facts, but are true for certain devotees and do not necessarily apply to all. These descriptions, even if considered overestimations, must be taken as they are, in order to divert our attention from the fleeting material beauty to the eternal beauty of Krishna consciousness. You see how, actually the original verse says that Bahirmukha, those who are Bahirmukha. So those who are turned their face against Krishna, basically non-devotees. So Prabhupada, he very nicely he puts here, in order to divert our attention from fleeting material beauty to the eternal beauty of Krishna consciousness. And for a person who is already in contact with Krishna consciousness, the described results are not unusual. And for devotees, this is another point. Prabhupada here, he says that for devotees, these are all side products. And particularly that Bilva Mangala Thakur verse, Prabhupada used to often quote that those who are engaged in, that is from Krishna Karnamrita. It is a book written by Bilva Mangala Thakur. So there are 113 verses are there in that. So one of the verses says that a devotee is, so Mukti Devi, Mukti or liberation stands at the door of a devotee. So Samaya Pratishta, waiting for devotee to accept her. So Mukti Devi, she stands. That means devotee does not care for liberation also. So, but they are automatically dharma, artha, kama, moksha, they are side products of bhakti. The main product is love of Godhead. So for that also Rupa Goswami, he gives example that just like when a queen starts walking, along with the queen, there are many others will also start walking. She has her assistants, subordinates. So similarly, when Bhakti Devi or love of Godhead is there, then all this dharma, artha, kama, moksha, they automatically follow. The queen of bhakti, actually. So these things are all described in Bhagavad Gita, in this Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. So Prabhupada clearly says it is not overestimation, and it is meant for diverting. So these can be achieved, those who are already very pious and liberated, they can achieve, they can attain these results, they can experience these results. And for devotees, we don't do devotional service for the sake of such insignificant results. We do devotional service for achieving love of Godhead. And these are meant to divert our attention, or those who are non-devotees, those who are bahirmukha, to make them antarmukha, or to turn them towards Krishna, sevanmukha. So these results are offered. And because with that desire, they may come to devotional service, and in the end, what happens? They become pure devotees. So, and for a person who is already in contact with Krishna consciousness, the described results are not unusual. So, this is a takeaway what we can understand from these statements in Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. Any questions, comments?